recently shared some important information with me. She has changed the way she draws doggies to distinguish them from kitties. She used to draw them both with their ears perked up, but now she draws dog ears all floppy to clear up any confusion this caused. She told me this so seriously, and it sent me into thinking about how we attach importance to things and how those things are always changing. And in some ways, it's especially intense when you're a kid, but it's still there for me now. There's just different places I put it. I really wish I could go back to when I would play entire baseball games on my driveway, and I would keep track of every pitch and every hit and every fielding error, and I was doing them all myself, but it was so important to me to be accurate. Which was funny, cause a lot of it I had decide for myself. Like maybe I miss the strike zone, pretend the batter swung to get the out, or if my favorite player was at the imaginary plate. Maybe with a wink to myself, I intentionally let the ball roll between my legs. And yet, despite the inherent instability, the objective measurement of every play, I had notebooks upon notebooks filled with the stats of every game. And I tabulated league standings and statistics as if the universe hung in the balance, which in a way, for me it did, and that's the point. There was so much meaning I attached. But at some level too, I needed someone else to care. With my dad and brothers, my pretend baseball season results needed to be shared. So like when I spent months building a new board game all by myself, and my friend didn't want to play, it was a pretty tough pill to swallow. Why I listen so intently to Samia's dog and cat drawing update. Cause if it matters to her right now, then it matters to me. And if I may, I think this is a pretty fundamental part of the human experience that many of us lack. The idea that we're doing something important and that other people can see it and react. Which I guess brings me around to the elephant in my own room, which is songs like this and the albums I keep making, sending out into the gloom of a world where everyone is busy, has limited attention to spend for some guy in his late 30s writing long-ass songs about seemingly random shit with moderate production quality. I completely get it. In fact, I'm aware that by objective standards, the books and interviews and opinions I put out into the world are more often seen and heard than most other people's, and I'm deeply grateful for all that interest. So far be it for me to complain. A new album is less than 100 hits. But all the same, for all the thought I spend on crafting every line, I know there is part of me that really needs someone to say, Tyler, I listened to your song and I'm crying. It just so perfectly captured something that I too have thought about so many times. It made me feel more connected to you and the world and myself and what it is to be alive.